My name is Alan Hawse. I'm Vice President of Technical Staff for Solutions and Software at Cypress Semiconductor. Welcome to my video series on PSoC BLE, our revolutionary new Bluetooth solution. When I started thinking about these lessons, I first took a look at how most people introduce new engineers to Bluetooth, and I really didn't like what I found. So I'm going to do things a little bit differently. I'm not going to show you a picture of the stack and drone on and on and on about what each layer does. When you teach someone to drive, you don't start by teaching them the intricacies of internal combustion engines. It's just too painful and nobody will pay attention. So I'm going to start with the simple example of a Find Me tag. These tags are the little battery-powered things that you can attach to your car keys, or really whatever. Then, when you lose them, you can trigger the tag to flash or beep or whatever using your cell phone. I'll talk about all of the pieces of this example as I add functionality to it. And then, in future lessons, I'll build on to that example. If you watch these lessons, then repeat what I do here with your kit, then you should understand all of the BLE concepts required to get started with your product. For this first project, I will use the Pioneer kit with the red radio module. The red LED on the baseboard will serve as the visual indication that the Find Me service has been triggered. First, let's create a new project. Make sure you select PSoC 4100 BLE / PSoC 4200 BLE in the new project dialog. Next, add the BLE component to your schematic. As with all PSoC Creator components, you just double-click to open the customizer dialog. All BLE devices are implemented with profiles. A profile is just the BLE word for a Bluetooth SIG specified collection of data and functionality, which are called services. Some examples of these profiles include things like heart rate monitors, bike power meters, and running speed indicators. It's also possible for you to create your own custom profiles, which I'll talk about in the last lessons. When you choose a standard profile, PSoC Creator automatically selects the correct services and characteristics for it. We program PSoC Creator to know all about the standard requirements for each of these profiles. This will greatly simplify your work. A service is quite simply the thing that a device can do, and a characteristic is all of the information that can be shared. Services and characteristics are also specified by the Bluetooth SIG, but once again, you could create your own services and characteristics. However, for your first design, we're just going to use the standard services. All right, let's get started. First, select the standard Find Me profile. PSoC Creator will automatically create a GAT peripheral that implements the standard GAT server Find Me profile. These two acronyms, GAP and GAT, are the fundamental concepts to understanding BLE. The acronym GAP stands for Generic Access Profile. You can think of GAP as the mechanism by which two devices get connected, your cell phone and your project. GAT stands for Generic Attribute Profile. You can think of GAT as the way that connected devices exchange the actual data. So GAP is what enables connections, and GAT is how you exchange data. As we move forward, I will talk about these concepts in more detail. Now back to our project. The Find Me profile can be used to either send or receive alerts. In our application, we will be receiving alert requests from a cell phone. For this example, you will be implementing a device that serves in the role of a GAT server. BLE was modeled after the World Wide Web client-server model. The device that has the data is called the server, or more specifically and more accurately, the GAT server. The device that wants to read or write the data is called the client, or more specifically, the GAT client. For this application, the GAT client will be your cell phone, which will write to the Pioneer Board's GAT server. The connection between BLE devices is established using GAP. The two main roles in GAP are the GAP central, which is most often played by a cell phone, and the GAP peripheral, which is most often the thing you're building. Our device is capable of serving in both of these roles, and in fact switching between them. However, that's pretty complicated and is outside of the scope of these getting started lessons. For this application, we choose to use the most common setup, where your device is a GAT server and a GAT peripheral. In the Profiles tab, you can see the definitions of all of the profiles. They're denoted with the little P. You can see the services. They're denoted with the little S. And the characteristics, and they're denoted with the little C. All of this configuration data is held automatically for you in a database called the GAT database. This database is provided for you by Cypress and is part of the BLE stack. All BLE peripherals are required to implement a GAP and a GAT service. These are the first two services you see in your configuration, and they're both handled for you automatically by PSoC Creator. The last service you see is the immediate alert service, which contains the alert level characteristic. The alert level characteristic is the actual thing that will be changed by the cell phone GAP Central to cause the LED to blink. You can see on the configuration screen that it can be one of three values: no alert, mild alert, or crazy high alert. For now, accept all of the defaults and then move on to the GAP settings. Remember, I said earlier that GAP is a protocol that defines how devices connect. In this next section, we will configure the connection parameters of your device, specifically how often and what your device advertises. First, assign a name to your device. This string of characters will be used when the device advertises its presence and makes the connections with other devices. I'll also ask the device to generate its own unique ID number by checking this little box. Every Bluetooth device is required to have a unique ID. This ID is also known as the Universally Unique ID, or UUID. When I check this box, the device will generate a unique ID based on information that is embedded in every PSoC 4 BLE chip. To make it easier to find the device when I look for it on my phone, I need to ask the component to include the name of the device in the advertising packet. I'll also ask to advertise the service UUID, because that prevents this phone from showing my device as having an unknown service. And we'll see that working for us in the next lesson. That's all I need to do to set up a BLE peripheral that I can control with my phone or tablet. In the next lesson, we will build the rest of the project and implement the firmware required for the Find Me profile. I hope this lesson helps explain some of the basic BLE terminology and gives you an idea of what you can do with the component. Please try this out for yourself. Create a project and add the BLE component, then explore the dialog and the profiles that it allows you to configure. As always, you're welcome to email me at alan_hawse@cypress.com with your comments, suggestions, criticisms, and questions.